Family members of the 4-year-old boy who drowned on Monday want the conflicting media reports regarding the child's death to stop. Terrell Joshua Elibox, according to family members, was on a church outing when tragedy struck after he was suddenly taken without their permission.
Saturday, we went to the beach to have a little church gathering.
Sunday.
And while we were there, my grandson and a little sister at the age of 16 to 17 was on the sand playing. While they were there playing, making sand castle, a little while my daughter came calling, "Mommy, mommy, look, a white man grab the child and go with him." By the time she called, I ran down, I met Pastor Rudy's wife already going and look for the child. I sent and called Pastor Rudy, and that was it. That is not made for two people. That's made for only one person. How you can just take somebody's child without permission and just go with it? Go with him.
I just want to clarify, because I've read a lot of comments and feedback from the media and individuals. Terrell's, my mother, who's TJ's grandmother, did not under any circumstance give that the visitor or the guest, whoever it was, riding the surfboard, permission to take TJ on the surfboard with him. Yes, he literally grabbed the child out of the young lady's hand, the 16-year-old girl's hand, based on what we were told by persons who were there.
Family members say that young TJ was taken onto a surfboard without a life jacket by a stranger who was surfing, and during the ride, he fell into the sea. The religious leader who organized the beach outing says that there were other surfers offering rides to children, but no one gave the stranger permission to take TJ.
Yesterday I saw some news on the media. I want to let the people know that they need to be careful what they're listening to and what they're broadcasting. This information was not coming from people that was on the site that was there when the incident happened. We were at Bwashado and not at Kitch. What they were showing the beach at Kitch, which is very rough. We were at Bwashado, which is a place that is very shallow.
The school where the 4-year-old boy attended is shocked and saddened by the news. The administrator recounts a last moment with the toddler.
When he would be leaving, he would come and tell me, "Teacher, I'm leaving. Teacher, I'm going." And he would just put his arms out and hug me. And the Friday, I remember the Friday he came to school and he was the only one in uniform. And I was telling him, "Today, my boy, you came to school with uniform and you shouldn't have uniform. You should have your clothes, because they wear normal clothes on Friday." And he turned all around looking at the children. And when he was leaving, I said to him, "Bye-bye, see you on Monday." And his grandmother said, "God's willing," and not knowing that that would have happened.
The body was discovered on Tuesday at around 6 a.m. near the Coconut Bay Beach. An individual is presently assisting police with the investigation. The incident took place on Bwashado Beach in Vieux Fort. For the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.